Welcome to Movie of the Year, the only podcast that has the science and the screaming to unequivocally figure out what the best movie is of any given year. This year is 1996, but tonight, as last week, we are not talking about movies. That's right, folks. It is part two of 1996 Mixtape. I'm your host, Mike Gravano. With me, there's Ryan.
So many nines in the year. Like, how do you... You just lose control at a certain point.
99999, Greg.
It looks like one of them just, like, did a little bit of a somersault and now doing a headstand.
And Nate, our pal from Debut Buddies.
I'm Nate. I'm here. It's the 90s.
Nate, is Nate pulling
whatever,
like
as if a
David Spade where he's trying to get his catchphrase from SNL? Like, yeah. I'm Nate, I'm here. Is that what
I'm
he
Nate,
wants?
I'm here. Yeah, try to give that to somebody else, Lauren. I'm Nate, I'm here. Who else can say that?
I'm here, I'm present, get used to it.
This, like I said, is part two. We're going in order. It is Greg, Nate, me, Ryan. Greg had the first song. Ryan has the last song. Anything else can be shimmied and moved and placed anywhere. Greg, before we jump right in, run down that current status.
Glad to do it, Mike. Coming in at number one, our opener. It's not moving. It's not going anywhere. It's going to be the opener. Rage Against the Machine's Bulls on Parade. Then we have Weezer doing El Scorcho. MXPX doing Chick Magnet. We have No Doubts, Just a Girl, followed by Beck, Where It's At. And Soul Coughing with Super Bon Bon, Butthole Surfers with Pepper, The Sneaker Pimps with Six Underground, Fugees with Killing Me Softly, Bone Thugs and Harmony with Crossroads, Nas featuring Lauryn Hill, If I Ruled the World, Fiona Apple, Shadowboxer.
Super Bon Bon still TBD. Holding it up as the song. We're like, oh, they listened to some, you know, underground music. Oh, no. It's just the most obvious picks.
Ouch. I think there's more obvious ones we haven't picked yet. Maybe we will now. Do you think there's some sick masochist who misses the era where we would, when Greg would do that, we would make a different person on the panel sing a bit of the song, Mike, even if they had never heard the song before?
Thanks for asking. You know how hard it was to not sing every song? I knew that Greg would plow through, right? Like, if I started singing, he'd be like, no. Ryan,
I would use the power of my voice to drown it out. Yeah,
he's the only person I know who like has a louder voice than I do. And I thought I had to help hold myself back.
My voice gets so loud that my watch will tell me that I'm in an area that's too loud, but it's just me.
Just jerking off.
It's just the sound of my voice.
Your own voice is hurting your ears.
Yep. That's true.
Life. That's living.
That's called sustainability.
I'm a loud boy.
Your voice is sending pencils into your ears like some sort of Butthole Surfers cover.
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good. Let's dive in. Greg, your pick.
Okay. This is where I just have to, you know, I have to do an accounting of myself, and I have to admit this was my taste of time. I think a lot of people had this taste of the time. I don't think it's my fault. I was all about this band, and this band is Sublime. And which are you going to pick from Sublime, self-titled Sublime, Ryan? I don't know if you had this same issue, but I was like, I don't want to go too Sublime-y, and I want one of their songs that is like the least offensive.
Do you want to support riots? Do you want to support pawn shops?
Do you want to support like dating a 12-year-old girl? Like there's another song about like beating up your girlfriend and then beating up the guy that she, so what I went with. It's the one they play on the radio a lot, and they literally, I think they wrote this song to be a single that people would like. It's What I Got by Sublime. The least offensive, the most radio-friendly Sublime song.
Except for that guitar song.
Early in the morning, rising to the street. Light me up that cigarette, I'll strap shoes on my feet. Got too far. Reason things went wrong. Got to find a reason why my money's all gone.
One of the most perfect songs of all time because later on in the song, in the bridge, there's an orchestra hit and everyone gets to go bop with that one. So that's all I need for music.
Man, I gotta say, even listening to it now, I still get a little rowdy. I know, like, I have been told my worst music crime is liking this band. Although, honestly, looking at 96, I could do you one worse, Wallflowers, but this song is a bop. It's fun. It gets me going. It gets me moving. And situated, you know, right after No Doubt, right before Beck, which is where I'm putting it, is very true to the K-Rock vibes of 1996, Greg.
Let me ask you this. Do you want to be a fucking dork or a liar? If you leave this off, you're a liar.
Can't it be both?
And from what I got to where it's at, the two best prepositional phrases?
Our English teacher contingent.
I mean, it's not. It's
in the audience, I mean.
Is what I got a prepositional phrase, though?
I don't know. Shut up. Let's move on. I was leaving a bar last night. I'm just trying to just keep talking. I was leaving a bar last night, and karaoke was starting, and somebody was doing Bad Fish, which is a weird opener to a karaoke night because it's a pretty mellow song. But also, like, underplayed Sublime song in that Bad Fish. Not from this year.
You've been in Colorado too long, homie.
Oh, my goodness.
That's true.
That is, like, one of the ones... I would say that's the most, at this point, that's probably the most played Sublime.
It's not Wrong Way anymore? Because that maybe they finally
were like, they don't even play Date Rape anymore. Like, because why would you?
My entire life, Bad Fish has been the Red Hot Chili Peppers Sublime song of all time.
Yeah.
Like, Bad Fish is nonstop.
Well,
fuck ain't got no quarrels with God on that one.
Was second pick Santeria?
Yes, but that's, you know, and Santeria is probably my favorite track off the album. But it's just, I don't know. First of all, like, there's so much violence and weirdness in that song, and it just reminded me of so much of the violence and weirdness contained elsewhere in Sublime. I wanted, like, just a little bit more of just, like, the positive, poppy, single Sublime.
Just, like, full-on dog neglect music.
It's a sub-sub-sub-genre, but it's an important one. One of my favorite things in music is when they are talking about how great music is, and then after a while you realize they're talking about this particular song that they're playing right now. Like, walking to the party and hope they play the perfect song, but they're singing the perfect song that they hope to be played. And this song has I Can Play the Guitar Like a Motherfucking Riot, and then the least riotous guitar solo of all time.
It's a
somebody's child ran
joke, up. Right? Yeah. It's like, yeah, I just picked up a guitar today, and this is what I think a solo would sound like. And then he whistles for a little bit of it. That's not so.
That's how good he is at guitar. It's coming out of his mouth.
Yeah, it sounds like a whistle.
But, you know, wasn't he right when he said, life is short, so love the one you got? Because you might get run over, and you might get shot.
Look, those are two things that I have to deal with every day, and that's why I settled.
All right. Nate Money, you're up.
Okay. We haven't delved into another very obvious 96 pick. This one inarguably takes the cake. We need to go the distance together. And I think that it needs to happen probably right after I'm Just a Girl.
Thumping in time, the green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty except for one man, still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving
Love that you picked Cake. I would have done with Stick Shifts and Safety Belts, but I'm a fashion nugget lover. My biggest bone to pick, Nate, is that you put it where you put it and not with the block of every other guy who sings like this. You put it in between No Doubt and Sublime and not with Beck, Soul Coughing, and Butthole Servers. That's crazy.
Well, I figured we needed to crawl back a little bit. We need to remember where we came from.
Or just
plus, he's literally staying there, continuing to race, even though the race is over. So thematically, it works.
Sure.
He shouldn't be where he is.
That's dangerous.
But he is anyway, because he's going the distance.
I like this idea that this mixtape will have two different sections of boys just talking.
Yeah. 96, a time for dudes to talk
now
to dudes about
the boys
dudes
shall talk.
But, like, this is a perfect example of what we were talking about in the last episode of got a great groove, right? It's vibes over Rocky Now or Learning Messages. And yet it still almost feels like novelty,
yeah.
Right? It still almost feels like comedy. We're not sure what you're doing. Maybe it's not full Primus. Maybe it's not full Harvey Danger.
Yeah.
But like it's in that area.
Definitely. Yeah. And it's like there's sort of like a tongue-in-cheekness to it, but still so, like you say, so groovy. Mm-hmm. I mean, and people get fired up when they hear this song.
I'm going to bridge the gap between is this parody and our more dancey hip hop and say, what if somebody made a song about how they're returning? Mac is back and Return of the Mac, the titular album and the amazing song. I'm going to put Return of the Mac. I'm going to say between Sneaker Pimps and Fugees.
Weren't you guys confused by this song though? Because like you don't remember when the Mac was initially here,
dude. Same thing with Backstreet Back.
Yeah,
Backstreet's Back. That was the first song I ever heard by that band. So I was like, "Back from where? What are you talking
where
about?
Where were you?
Leave me alone.
Lunch. Back from lunch.
And now
how
it's
was
fifth
it?
Period.
All right.
It's. Do you know what's doubly confusing? Is Return of the Mac. Name of the song, name of the album. Sure, so this singer's name is Mac? No, it's Mark. He missaid his own name in the song and went, nope, that's what I meant.
Even more confusing, we have a friend, Mac, friend of the show, who hasn't been on the show in a long time, but she's not back yet.
Even triple downing on the confusion, why don't we play that song when she comes back?
Yeah.
That should be her entrance music.
I remember being confused by this song, and then do you guys remember somebody who seemed to be very famous and now has a biopic coming out where a chimpanzee plays him in the biopic? Robbie Williams. Do you guys remember hearing about that guy?
I vaguely remember
he was
Robbie
with the
Williams
too.
He was, yes.
Yeah.
All right, up next it's Ryan.
Oh shit. Okay, so let me look at this. I think that I'm gonna go in between Nas and Fiona Apple. No, you know what? I'm going to go after Fiona Apple. I don't know what the end holds for us, but do we have to slow it down even more than Fiona can? And I don't know why this song was so important to me.
First song you jerked it to.
First song. I was a freshman in 96.
See, that's the thing. It was Greg.
I knew everything. Yeah.
Were you guilt-stricken sobbing with your head on the floor, Greg?
Yes, all the time.
And I think this is the verb pipe with the freshman. And I think it's important to point out that in this era, much like there was two Canadian football teams named the Rough Riders, why was there a verb pipe and a verve? Like, why did we just let that happen?
I do not know.
Hey, the Verve, change your name to the Rough Riders.
Yeah. Hey, Rough Riders, one of you, I don't care which. Change your name to the Verve.
You should be the Verve.
Welcome to the stadium, the Verve. Yeah, this is a song that I feel like is very time bound. Like, do you think you would hear this song for any other reason than purposely seeking it out yourself?
Oh, I would hit eject on the CD player and then finding out that it's not playing on CD, throw my entire radio out the window if I heard this song. But it's the Shawshank of songs. It's like clearly going for those emotions that if you're that age, it just works.
Every life from me, I remember.
Similar to Shawshank, if you make fun of a friend for liking it, they will go on a unhinged 30-paragraph text diatribe of why it means you don't believe in women's right to choose. That's right, Producer Dave. I'm calling your weird ass out on the show.
He's a passionate man.
You know, though, that he had that text rant saved, right?
Yeah.
On his, like, clipboard, and then just throws it out to no matter who says what.
All right, that is a great first round for the part two of the mixtape. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, everybody's last choice. It all ends here after four more choices and reading the whole list a few more times, probably. But it all ends here with you, Greg.
Okay, so I'm going to go into this slow section that we've got developing in the end, and I'm going to go in the middle of it between Fiona Apple and the Verve pipe. And again, putting myself on blast, this liking this band has become synonymous with being a basic white guy with no taste. But the Dave Matthews Band was a big band at the time, okay? And they were important to a lot of people, including me and my wife. And we loved listening to Dave Matthews Band together as a young couple. And we haven't for probably over 20 years. But we loved it back then, back in the day. The band song Crash Into Me, a song that I heard with my dad once. And when it was done, he went, "That's a very erotic song." But I like it anyway.
I gave you a skinny boy.
This is 5 minutes, and I think Greg and I are going to sing this whole song.
Please do.
It's kind of like nice slow build up here. You've got your
ball, you've got your it sucks so much.
Kind of a little sexy, sultry sound. It's even sexier when you realize he looks like Joe Triglio from Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
Yeah. Imagine a world where Joe Lotruglio and his best friends dumped 8 tons of shit on people in a river.
I have seen computer animations of that. The Dave Matthews Band, they're like, "Hey, you know what? We're parked on this bridge. One thing we can do is dump 8 tons of waste out of the tour bus." What they didn't know was that sometimes people are going under bridges, maybe on like an open-topped tour boat to see the sights. And boy, did they ever see the sights.
I just believe that being rich means that if your pilot is in a vehicle that you own, there are switches and levers and toggles for everything you could ever want, and they flip that lever.
Drop the shit on the proles. Here, watch this as it crashes into you, huh? And my shit comes into your boat. Have a good day.
Into your mouth.
The fact that it's 8 tons, they should have done that earlier, right? That's too much. I know the capacity is clearly there, but, like, do a safety drop.
Give this song to a girl I liked at this time.
Yes.
On a mixtape that was mostly focused on this song. And her response to this girl that I had a huge crush on was, "That song was perverted."
Yeah.
And that was the last time we talked romantically.
Yeah.
Because freshmen don't get eroticism.
They just get the song, The Freshman. They're the titular character.
Well, because if you're 17, you are freaked out by the idea, "I'm the king of the castle, you're a dirty rascal." Like, what? I don't know.
I legit thought it was asshole till right now. I'm the king of the castle and you're a dirty asshole.
Damn, that
better song.
That would be pretty intense.
But there's also "Lift Up Your Skirt a Little More and Show Your World to Me."
Yeah.
"Crash Into Me and I'll Come Into You." Like
in a boy's dream.
I think that at the time that was reckoned to be subtle, but
yeah.
"I'll come into what?"
What could that mean?
Yeah, that's not
what are
you
calling an NFL game?
I think people were just so stoked that there was a Dave Matthews song that was only 5 minutes that they were like, "Yes, we love it."
I would rather watch Cronenberg's Crash 8 times in a row than listen to that song once ever again in my entire goddamn life.
I tense
life.
Up every time that movie's even mentioned. I can feel myself going, ugh.
But I'm on the mixtape, like, without a doubt.
Yeah, it's on there.
It is inarguably there. And I like it. It always bums me out when there's a mixtape without a song I can skip, so now I know when to go pee.
Plus, skipping one of the 5-minute songs, that's saving yourself some time.
Nate Pants, you're up.
Okay. I'm going to go... we put Crash Into Me at the end after Fiona?
It's It goes Shadow Boxer at 15, Crash at 16, and The Freshman at 17.
Okay, great.
Emotional ending, right? Now.
I want to slide right in between Crash and Fiona there.
Alrighty.
And we're going to go with a very classic song of longing for love by the Cardigans, titled Love Fool. You love it.
This is a good one. We haven't talked about how Romeo plus Juliet is not in the season. Mm-hmm. We haven't talked about how important this soundtrack was.
When it looked like it was going to make it into the season, we got so excited about having, because we were going to talk about Johnny Legs, John Leguizamo, the whole time.
I know.
And then when it got bumped out, it was like funereal in the room. We were so sad. But
aww, yeah.
And then we were going to have one of Caitlin's relatives on the show, and then it would have just been Caitlin.
Dear, I fear we're facing a problem. You love me no longer, I know, and maybe there is nothing that I can do to make you do.
Nate, I love this pick with your, and we're going to hear the Cardigans coming up pretty soon, but
I'm going to get to the real song.
I love this pick with your Six Underground pick. Do you know the Cardigans outside of this song?
I also love Losing My Favorite Game. That's actually one of my favorite, like, songs of all time. It's like a little rip.
I got into a big debate with 20-year-olds the other night, which is awful.
You're so cool.
Because they were saying that Espresso by Sabrina Carpenter is a good song because it's catchy. Uh-huh. And I would say, no, it's the worst song ever written. Part of it is because it's catchy. I don't think that about Love Fool. It's catchy as fuck and an incredible song.
Yeah, well we're right about our music, and they're wrong about theirs. It's as simple as that.
An important differentiator is the Cardigans are Swedish, and Sabrina Carpenter is not.
and
that's pretty
the
much
Swedes
the only qualifier required.
But also, like, and Sabrina Carpenter has better songs than Espresso, but the Cardigans can sing. But it sounds like she's making fun of Simple Plan or other pop punk bands the way she says, I'm working late, cause I'm a singer.
There's a TikTok going around right now with Sabrina Carpenter hanging out with Christina Aguilera. And the reason I bring this up, Mike, is because do you think that should be the cast of Burlesque 2?
Yes. And I will see it once again in theaters. Okay. What do I do with my life? Oh, it's my turn.
Indeed it is.
Indeed. Some people say parties should have a lot of diggity. But in my opinion, there should be no diggity.
Can you back that
at
up?
At all. I think I can back that up and bag that up, which is when I karaoke'd it with my HR guy at a work function, I learned it was not back that up, it was bag it up. And I went, it's going to be weird for everybody on Monday.
And what does that mean in this context, do we think?
What
I mean, you're not coming into anybody in a boy's dream.
I would say put your groceries in a condom.
Fade to Black Street, the homies got at me. Collab creations, bump like agony, no doubt. I put it down, never slouch. As long as my credit can vouch, I talk.
And we're gonna put that. Where should that go? Where's like dancey? Is there anything dancey? I guess after. No, that's more mellow. Fuck, I got nothing. After Sneaker Pimps.
All right, very good. I'll slide that right in between Sneaker Pimps, Six Underground, and Mark Morrison's Return of the Mac. I think that works, Mike. I think it's a good choice.
But thank yeah, like you. Let's shout out right now that this is a post-party mix that we have created.
Like once the party is done.
Yeah, half the people have gone home, and it's just your friends. This is what you put on.
Just like the year 1996. The party was done. We were just all waiting to go home.
I don't think I had ever been to like what we would now consider a party in 1996. I'd been like to a child's birthday party, right? Like where we bowl and like get cupcakes. But I don't think I'd ever been to any of it. It was just like a bunch of people hanging out.
D&D sleepover is a type of party, right?
Yeah, sure. Definitely, Nate.
I miss bowling and cupcakes parties. There's something to do. You don't just sit in the corner and go.
Stand in one big circle, and then if it gets quiet for even a second, someone goes, awkward! And you're like, no, it's not awkward. We just can't be talking the whole time.
Random! No, it's not that either. Like, why are you yelling words?
I'm lonely! Oh,
aren't we all? Ryan.
Yes.
It all comes down to you.
Oh, this is it? This is the last song of the thing?
Is the last song.
Wow. This is Kara Sedgwick. You're the closer.
We are going to have back-to-back Ryan, because I am going to put this last. We're going to do a song that has gained in popularity over the last 5 years or so, but I just want to say that I loved it when it came out.
The Queen herself.
We're probably in for like a 20-minute intro here.
Well, that's the kind of presence she has.
I know.
It's like for the listeners who don't... for our young listeners, Ryan, well, who is this and what is it?
Celine Dion.
This is Celine Titanic.
Come back to me now. Soulful.
I didn't think that intro would be this long, though.
No.
It's very long. Best or worst karaoke pick? You think probably because you're 10 minutes up there waiting to be able to sing.
There were nights when the wind was so cold that my body froze in bed if I just listened to it right outside the window. There were days when the sun was so cruel. Tears turned to dust, and I just knew my eyes were drying up forever.
I'm gonna move ahead a little bit.
A little hard.
It's so hard to resist, and it's all coming back to me. I can barely recall, but it's all coming back to me now.
Wow, so powerful. Honestly, you go to sort of tease the song, but she's very talented. She's a very good artist.
There's a very old clip, and I know James Corden, whatever, but she's on Carpool Karaoke, and he's just playing her songs, and then he is trying to sing them as good as she can, because I don't know how to sum up James Corden better
than
that.
Yeah, exactly.
There's people outside the car when this song is on, and they recognize her. She rolls down the window, and this song is blaring, and she doesn't start singing the song. She sings it at them, like a barking dog with her head out the window. And they get they're enamored, they're impressed, but also a little bit scared. And I think that's what Celine Dion does to me.
It's a very A24 like horror set piece to just have Celine Dion pull up and start screaming, "It's all coming back to me" at you.
Well, it's a strong ending.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think it leaves them with like an emotional sort of finale to the whole thing.
And what I was wondering is that if Greg reads the songs and then I sing each song, how Celine Dion would sing that song.
Yes. That is what I would like to hear, and the listeners would like to hear, and most of all, Nate would like to hear.
I actually emailed about this several weeks ago, so I'm really happy this is coming true.
What a coinkydink.
All right, so here we go, Ryan. Are you ready?
I'm absolutely not doing this.
He's not doing it, but maybe I'll tell them what the playlist is anyway.
Sure.
We'll allow that.
Okay. Or should we do some HMs first? What should we do first, Mike? Some HMs?
Let's read the list and then do HMs.
Okay. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. This is your playlist. It is final now.
Locked in.
Starting off with Rage Against the Machine, Bulls on Parade, Weezer with El Scorcho, MXPX with Chick Magnet, No Doubt, Just a Girl, Cake, Going the Distance, Sublime, What I Got, Beck, Where It's At, I like those back-to-back, Soul Coughing, Super Bon Bon, Butthole Surfers with their song Pepper, Sneaker Pimps with Six Underground, Black Street with No Diggity, Mark Morrison with Return of the Mac, Fugees with Killing Me Softly, Bone Thugs and Harmony with Crossroads, Nas featuring Lauryn Hill, If I Ruled the World, Fiona Apple with Shadow Boxer, Cardigans with Love Fool, Dave Matthews Band with Crash, The Verve Pipe with The Freshman, Celine Dion with It's All Coming Back to Me Now.
What an insanely good mixtape that ends with the Cardigans. That is so fucking awesome. That's when I'm out of the house.
I believe you're also going to skip Dave Matthews Band Crash, if I'm not mistaken, Mike.
I think I'm leaving the house before that happens.
Hitting
pause on Spotify. You're going to walk away from your house and watch it explode in the background.
The party that this is playing at, I am gone with Love Fool.
And that's why you never have sex.
Yeah, and I'm fine with that. Because so I also Mike, don't dump 8 pounds of shit on anybody. That part's not true. Damn
you
it.
You would never.
I only do the bad parts of Dave Matthews, which is most Dave Matthews.
Can we do some HM action here?
Let's do HM action, but not Greg because he's too eager for it. Nate, what are your HMs?
I had a couple classics from this era would be Push by Matchbox 20.
Yes.
A Long December by Counting Crows. And Wannabe by the Spice Girls.
Yeah.
If we really want to tell them what we want, what we really, really want.
I do think that looking back on this, one, this playlist has Dave Matthews, so congratulations to all four of us. But two, I feel like it's a little pop light, like corn pop light.
It's hard that there's a few modes on here, but it is pop would have felt wrong because you got Angry Talk Guy and punk leaning like is a general. And then you got like kind of dancier hip hop stuff. Pop in general would have felt Spice Girls belong on Dr. Demento more than any other song that's on this mixtape. Greg, yeah, what are your HMs?
Okay, so first I have to give a big HM to a band that I really wanted to include, but I could not, which is Metallica came out with perhaps their most reviled album in 96 called Load. And I was listening to the songs today, but Ryan and Mike, we had a mutual friend from way back in the day who pointed out to me that around this time in Metallica, James Hetfield, every lyric, everything he sings, he ends with, ha!
Yeah.
So he's like, James, Hetfield, And I was listening to Load, and he can't, like, it's like a verbal tick. He can't not do
it. He's the Tasmanian devil.
So it's all I could hear.
It's like when he's recording, he sings his lyric, but then he also needs his horse to go fast.
Hero of the day, yeah! And then the other one I had to give a shout out to, because I loved this band so much in 96. The Wallflowers, funny story, Jacob Dylan's dad was actually a recording artist as well, the lead singer of the Wallflowers.
Robert Zimmerman, you mean?
This is the most boring band in the history of music. Like, I don't know how they could be so boring, and I don't know why I used to like them, but I was very close to putting One Headlight.
One Headlight. My lovely wife, who I think often has great taste. loves the Wallflowers, and they came out with the album in the last couple of years, and she listened to it so much. And I'm whispering so she doesn't hear me.
Yes, the Wallflowers are like Bruce Springsteen taking the Valium from the Verve Pipe song and just sleeping through.
Yes, it sounds like he is falling asleep while he's singing every line. It sounds kind of like he's trying to do an impression of his father, but not in such a way that anybody would notice.
Do you know what it is, I think, is that like it's Nepo Baby Syndrome, but like in a different way, where like rock and pop songs are so easy, right? So I'll just do them real quick. I'm just going to do them real quick.
I think it's also this 90s thing of Jacob Dylan is Bob Dylan's son and he's hot.
Yeah.
Get this man a record contract. We need him in videos. And that's half the recipe.
That's a big part of it. Because if you see pictures of young Bob Dylan, he's like a cutie.
He's like Timothy Chalamet.
But Jacob Dylan is incredibly attractive at this time, 1996. Like, as handsome as a man could possibly be. And that handsomeness is inflected with Bob Dylan's original boyish charms. Mm-hmm. And so I do think that, like, that has a lot to do with it. You got to say, here's Bob Dylan's kid. And also, look how fucking hot this
guy is. We're like 3 years away from John Ritter's kid. And that's when music finally takes off. Also, Jacob Dylan doesn't know how to sing it. It should have been...
Thank you for that flawless impression, Ryan. As your reward, what are your HMs?
I had a couple, especially with the closer. My Fiona was going to be Criminal, and I thought that would be a good closer. Mm. Based on how we started at the beginning with the talking people, I don't know if you guys remember this song, but it was a song by the Primitive Radio Gods.
Yeah.
Called Standing Outside the Something with a Something.
Standing outside a broken telephone booth with spare change in my hand.
Thank you, Gregory. and I think that would have fit perfectly, but like not enough to like waste a pick on. And then the other closers were Genuine by Pony or Pony by Genuine. I can't believe we didn't mention that. And then Swallowed by Bush. We thought that Bush was just like a one album wonder, and then Swallowed came out and it was amazing.
Did they talk to Dave Matthews Band or the Bag It Up situation? Look, there's a lot of sex stuff going on. That's all I'm saying.
96 was a extremely horny time.
Super horned.
Because what's 96 backwards, guys? Come on. Put it together.
But the clues are all there.
It's a palindrome.
Mine are the one I knew I couldn't do, like it was just never gonna fit anywhere. But I love the Yonetters, and That Thing You Do is a phenomenal song.
Do you think you'll
and
have a chance to talk about your love for that song at some point?
I don't think so. This might be. I know there's an episode I get to talk about my love for Captain Keach and the Shrimp Shack Shooters.
Yeah.
But I chose Chick Magnet to represent a batch of songs, and I was like, what is the lamest one but truest to me at this time? But New Girl by Suicide Machines, or Punk Rock Song Bad Religion, or Sell Out by Real Big Fish. All of the, they weren't all on Tony Hawk's Skate. Oh, that would have fit for sure. Yeah. But again, MXPX, they had some, I was going to say bangers, that's not right. They had some good tunes, those boys.
Do you just like it because it's one of Superman's archenemy's first names?
Yes. I think this is his song.
Mr. MXPX.
Mr. MXPX. Sings responsibility. Hey, this was fun. This is a good track. Good batch of tracks.
I think so.
Yeah, I think the people are gonna be happy with this one. This is what it's certainly what it sounded like to eat lunch in high school.
If you've ever liked a girl, but could only be across the room from her and no closer, this is the playlist for you.
Love Fool is where you're over the bravado of it and you're crying about that specific moment.
100%.
Nate, where can people find you?
You can find me at Debut Buddies. Every couple of weeks, we release a podcast. You can find us on Apple, Spotify, anywhere you get podcasts. It's a delightful show about firsts.
Wherever and podcasts are sold.
Man, they do. Fuck you, Wondery, for trying to sell podcasts. They should be free for the people. You can find this playlist on Spotify. I know you looked last week and it wasn't there. It's because we didn't want to give anything away, chuds. But now it is up there, 1,000%. Future me will definitely remember to put it up, and there's a link in the show notes.
He's past you now, Mike.
I hate past me. Past me always tries to fuck future me over. Writing checks my ass can't cash. For Nate, I'm Ryan, I'm Greg, we are all the world, and until next time, keep listening to those 1996 songs.
We're like 3 years away from John Goodman. And that's when music finally takes off. Also, Jacob Dylan doesn't know how to sing it. It should have been Wood, hood, 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 hood,